Hi, I am at this beautiful, mesmerizing island. It's called Sangaluma Island. It's in Australia. What I would like to talk about right now is solitude. What is solitude? So there is a difference in being alone and feeling lonely. Solitude is about being alone, enjoying your own company, and loving the time that you're spending with yourself. So that's about being alone and enjoying your own company. Feeling lonely is different. People can feel lonely even in a crowded room. People can feel lonely despite having lots of people around. That's a state of mind. That's different. Solitude is being with yourself and enjoying your own company. And recently, I've been doing a lot of that. And I'm simply loving it. There are three ways solitude can help you. Of course, more than three ways, but three ways that I'd like to talk about right now. Number one, solitude helps you know yourself better. We're surrounded with a lot of noise, external noise, people, crowd, so many things. There's the media, there's so much outside noise. But deep inside, if you reflect, there is blissful silence. And I like to take that time off to reflect within. So you can do this on a daily basis. I like to take a break every 2 hours. Whenever possible, just go to a quiet place and reflect within. Being in solitude strengthens your relationship with yourself. It makes you more aware about yourself, about the choices you make, about the decisions you take. It helps you dive deep within. And that journey inwards, believe me, is addictive. Once you get into that space, you're going to absolutely love it. This also helps you strengthen your relationship with yourself. See, the best and the most important relationship you will ever have is the one with yourself. I mean, come on, you are spending most time with yourself and you're doing so much of self-talk. You're talking to yourself. It's really important to reflect within and to find out whether you're talking the right things. Whether it's a negative self-talk or it's a motivating, positive, encouraging self-talk. So the number one reason, solitude helps you strengthen your relationship with yourself. Number two reason why spending time alone is important: it boosts creativity and productivity. Have you heard of authors, poets, or even musicians just going away to a secluded place, taking off like a 2 to 3 month vacation into a forest or an island and just reflecting time to write that book or create that master music piece? Do that. I'm telling you, do that. Go someplace. If you don't have the luxury of going someplace, go someplace nearby, or you can probably just stay in your home, but just go off social media, go off everything completely, switch off, spend some time alone, and work on a project that you maybe been delaying for a long time, or work on the project of your heart, something that you've been longing to do. I want to write a book and it's going to be titled Style Monk. So the basic idea is ready, but this thing has been going on for a year, that I want to write a book, but I've really made a decision that by the end of this year, 2019, I'm going to make sure that Style Monk is out. And Style Monk is all about loving yourself and having your own style and being a monk, being a modern stylish monk. So number two reason, solitude boosts creativity. Number three reason, solitude helps you love yourself more. It's very important spending time alone, read a book, get yourself a spa, get yourself a head massage, just go for a walk or do what you enjoy. it'll really strengthen the relationship you have with yourself. So solitude helps you love yourself more. It's very, very good psychologically for you. It's very, very good for your mind. It's incredibly soothing and healing experience to just hear the voice within. So repeating the three reasons how solitude can help you. Number one reason, solitude strengthens the relationship with yourself. Number two, solitude helps you boost creativity. And number three, solitude helps you love yourself more. Thank you.